Okay, hi guys. As you can see in the title, this is a review of Escape from Los Angeles, Escape from LA. And yeah. Now what I'm going to do is I'm not gonna put it full screen so it not get blocked. let's just remove the sound a little bit. Yeah, this is it. Basically, the thing is, I'm making this review to keep you updated. I wrote on Facebook. I wanna make prequel to Escape from Los Angeles, not New York, because I think New York suck major balls, and I mean doesn't suck, but here's the thing. For an action movie, it's in the wrong year with the wrong budget. This I'm talking about yeah, let's get this lower a little bit. Yeah, like this. So it's not get blocked. Here's the thing. Escape from Los Angeles has the right budget, the right year, the right cast, the right premise. Everything is just perfect. I mean, what can I say? This is 10 out of 10. This is masterpiece I can get. I'm not nostalgic, but I think it's too good for anyone. I love it as a kid. I love it more as an adult. Let's just see. Yeah, my video is boxed in some country. Let's see. Let's hope John Carpenter. Yeah, another. I mean, not underrated, but the thing is, that person is brilliant. I think it's even better song creator than director, because yeah, oh yeah, The Thing. I'm gonna review that. Yeah, next. The Thing. I don't like Halloween that much, but it's a great premise, and I'm going to make a prequel. The Thing I'm going to review it. Halloween I probably won't review it because I still want to be on John Carpenter's good side. Because if I, the thing is, this video is booked on his home country. He can go ahead and take the revenue. If someone deserves to take my money, it's him. I basically use his masterpiece of a song. I'm not gonna show you the song. Thing is, I want this to get copyrighted. He tell him you're gonna take it all. And now I'm gonna do it with my mouth. The song. It won't get copyrighted. You take it all. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Dun-dun-dun-dun. You basically get the point. And now basically this is a short review. I'm not gonna go for 10 minutes.
First, 6.
Oh yeah, this scene is the I laughed my ass off in this scene. It's so tragic, but it's sort of tragically funny. I just laughed my ass off in this scene. So basically, you just... Okay. Here's the thing, this is the best, best combination of action and sports. The scene when Snake Plissken will play a game of basketball. The rules are simple. You got 10 seconds to make a to hit a basket. But the thing is, you need to play on both baskets. So you need to score on another one, and then you got 10 seconds to score on the one, and 10 seconds to score to the other one. So yeah, basically, I don't think even Kobe Bryant can make it. I mean, he's the best player ever, but if you're under pressure, if you miss, you get shot. If you shoot after the buzzer, you get shot. Yeah, basically, it's, I think you should score 10 baskets and no 3 points, only 2 points. Or 5 baskets. Let's just see. I hope this song was recuperated. Okay. Let's just see. Then he start talking. Okay.
I promised you tonight was gonna be special. I gave you the death of Snake Plissken!
I know this is shitty review. I think it's... I don't want this to be what I want to be entertainment.
Some people think you're already dead, Snake. Some say you never will, because you may have survived Cleveland. You may have escaped from New York, but this is L.A., Vato, and you're about...
Yeah, the interesting thing is, I think John Carpenter is a conservative. I mean, look at the main villain. He's basically identical to Che Guevara. Yeah, Che Guevara was... henchman to Fidel Castro, who basically hardcore socialist. I mean, between more fascist than socialist. And yeah, that guy was the perfect maniac, perfect psychopath. And this guy is. Yeah, I don't think John Carpenter is a big fan of Che Guevara. Yeah, just enjoy. Let's see the rules again.
To find out that this fucking city can kill anybody!
Did you see the rules?
To find out that this fuck survived Cleveland. You may have escaped from New York, but this is LA, Vato. And you're about to find out that this fucking city can kill anybody!
I think we will see that it's fun. Or if not, I just want to count the bus.
Shot clock. Miss the shot, you get shot. Shot clock buzzer goes off before you shoot, you get shot. 2 points for a basket, no 3-point bullshit. All you gotta do is make 10 points.
Okay, that's five it. Baskets. In 2 courts. Yeah, I'm gonna try this
by
sometime.
The way.
You know what? I'm gonna try this sometime without pressure. Oh yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna try them, I'm gonna feel myself. Yeah, I'm gonna make it like 10 hours when I get in condition. That'll be awesome. Oh my god. And yeah, in the TV show, and I'm gonna make Snake Plissken how he's so good in basketball. Yeah, he'll be in the high school first team. He'll basically, I need to learn how to dunk. It's possible, I need to lose weight. I watched some YouTube videos with one. I'm 180 centimeters, 173 centimeters, the dunk the ball with both hands. I can't, if I am gonna aim to dunk it with one hand. And yeah, that would be awesome. If I could dunk, it would be much easier because I'm awful with you know two steps basket. How we call it? Okay, come, let's enjoy this.
Nobody's ever walked up that
floor. Review is 10 out of 10.
Nobody.
This is yeah. And this is the best combination of like I said of action and sports slash basketball. Yeah, I don't think Undisputed Trilogy, Boyka Trilogy is a good combination of martial arts and of sports and action because MMA is basic action. This is much different. I think John Carpenter in this movie was well ahead of his time. In this movie, yes, 5.7 from fans. I mean, really, I think 99% of people are Texas assholes. 1% of my subscribers. No, you don't need warm up. I like him, he's basically. Yeah. He's a little bit rusty, but. He was in the high school. He cannot play basketball since high school. And yeah, enjoy the intro because if John Carpenter won't give me green light to use his song, I'll basically just use Natal Dawkins and Tore Erba. They get the action songs and Roy Jones Jr. Nerd Lab Dance. What else? Actually, in the prequel, I'm gonna see if I can get my one coworker. She's a little bit young, 23 years, she looks like 15 years. I want her to play my sister. And yeah, I just want to. The first season will be. Basically, Snake Plissken in high school. Yeah, you do. Why you wanna watch that? But I just want to test myself with dramas. I mean, action is easy. You basically put some cool music and dress up. But the thing is, in high school drama is much different. First season high school drama, second season he'll go to military, and third season he'll basically become Snake Plissken. And yeah, his name. Isn't Snake because Snake is not a name. Nobody is named Snake. Snake is a nickname. He'll actually. He'll actually be beaten by a cobra. I think that's in his stomach. Yeah, I'm gonna make an actual tattoo of the cobra on my stomach, on my back. And of course. After I need to have six pack. Yeah, Kurt Russell didn't have like he was skinny and he looked like you wanna fuck him, but he didn't have a six pack like some roided up figures on X-Men movie. But the thing is, he had. He basically looked like a normal, in shape, skinny guy. And yeah, I'll make an actual tattoo with I'm gonna take a picture, I'm gonna download a picture of his tattoo and show it. I wanna say, make it exactly like that. And maybe download a video for when he dress up and he show his tattoo. Yeah, the thing is. I should probably watch Escape from New York, given another chance. Still, I love John Carpenter and his work. And yeah, this was his early work. And yeah, it shows that movie was boring as fuck. The thing is, if I need to learn from his mistakes and make a better, Snake Plissken shouldn't be my first my first featuring film. I should probably test with someone something else. I want to make short movies. Then will be probably when I make a decent featuring film. I'm gonna make. It's gonna be called Escape from San Francisco. This is a long feature. The thing is, yeah, I know Kurt Russell was young in Escape from New York. And yeah, I'm not gonna put the long hair. I just don't like long hair. It's a torture. This is a prequel kick. And yeah, I'm gonna play. Basically, first season, I'm gonna play it from beginning to end to high school. From first year to fourth year. Basically, I'll have like from 14 and then I'll turn 18. I'm gonna leave basketball. I'm gonna refuse to become professional basketball and go join the military because I'm a conservative patriot. And then the third season, basically, everything goes to shit. Social is not liberal, social is. Crazy socialist president will get in power and basically change the American institution. And yeah, basically this will be, there will be a lot of PC on and gender binary in the show. Yeah. This is actually, now I thought about that to make a more modern take. And in the movie, Snake Plissken will be called the TV show. The movie will be called Escape from San Francisco. That will be the first city where the crazy dictator or president. I don't know, I should think about how we're gonna change constitution, basically. First and Second Amendment, he will change it, you cannot look at guns. There's no free speech. You basically, if you some gender binary call Z, you get death sentence. Yeah, I'm gonna make it more extreme. If you call homosexual faggot, death sentence. From hate speech, that's the worst crime. You get death sentence. Maybe I'll go so far in death sentence for you and your close family, your mother, your father, your wife, your sister, your kid. I'll make it so extreme. Yeah, this is the movie NC-17. And I'm gonna hire some porn actors. I'm gonna make use of the NC-17 movie. Because this is a YouTube movie. Oh yeah, I cannot because it's YouTube. But I'm gonna cut the full frontal, I mean the nudity and the shit, and then I'm gonna put it on my porn site. I'm not gonna, I don't know if I'll get a strike if I get a link in the description to a porn site. I'll basically write what you need to type, X videos, I think fix is my username. I'm gonna write. No, I'm gonna take you. Yeah, what Facebook? What the fuck they're going to do Facebook? I'm gonna take you to Facebook, to my Facebook page, and then I'm gonna double link. Yeah, that's more smart because the people don't like type. They want to just click and go. Yeah, enjoy the rest of the rest. Okay. He scored the first. Let's see, this is the second. Yeah, I mean, this guy is look like a talented, rusty basketball player. Nice shot. He's getting tired now. He's still short. I mean, Kurt Russell is shorter than me, but I don't give a shit. I'm gonna cast tall actors. And I'm gonna look shorter in comparison. I probably should put up a lot of muscle to look shorter. And my neck, yeah, I need to work out my neck. I look too tall because it's too skinny. I own it. Okay, that's it. That's the review. I hope you enjoy it. The thing is, it's blocked in some countries. I'm gonna download. I'm gonna put it on Facebook. I'm gonna put the link in the description because I think John Carpenter, he's protective of his property. I don't have high hopes. I wrote him a nice message. I think that New York is Los Angeles is miles better than New York. And I said I hope you're gonna complete the trilogy, but if it doesn't, I'm here to take over. Escape from San Francisco, the first jailed city. For that, if some from the United States is watching, not now, when I have a decent budget, I mean, if my channel goes big, I need at least $10,000 to, I don't know, yeah, this is going to be, still, I'm going to film it in the United States, but it's going to be a YouTube movie. I need at least $10,000 just for off. I don't give a shit if I make any money. I just like making movies. I mean, and the offer will come if the movie is good. This basically it's not blind investment. I mean, if I make a good movie for $10,000 budget, if it's viral on YouTube, they'll make. Yeah, I'm gonna put link in the description in this video and yeah, I don't need this because some countries cannot see it. It's a promo for Snake Plissken / Escape from San Francisco. Snake Plissken is a TV show, Escape from San Francisco is a standalone movie. So basically I'm gonna put the link in the description for Facebook. I'm gonna upload it simultaneously with this video. I'm not gonna edit it, don't escape. I'm not gonna edit it, just this is 10 out of 10. I need to upload it fast. Bye.